my parents were farmers, so we were five in the family together with my parents, so it wasn't that easy to move on in life, to go on with my studies while helping at home. So this gave me, you know, a sort of determination to help others, as I found people who helped me through in these moments. By profession, I am a teacher, and I used to teach in a secondary school where the girls had an age bracket from 13 to 15, 16 year olds. And when in school, I used to meet teenagers who had problems, relationship problems with their parents and even sometimes with their boyfriend. So I always thought that it would be very helpful if there is a drop-in center or a home where these teenagers can find somebody to talk to, somebody who can help them by counseling and by giving them support. Our work is with single mothers, and single mothers were, you know, were not so much accepted in society. Sometimes we got a lot of resistance from the families, especially, you know, the parents. They are shocked when a teenage mother, you know, or a teenage father go up to them and tell them, I'm going to have a baby. They have dreams for them, you know, that they will go to their studies, university, get married, then have the baby. They were even turned out of their houses, of their homes, and they came here for shelter. So we had to, so as to fight this mentality and help the mother to obtain dignity and to be respected. So we have it here two ways. We have two ways of dealing with the situation. Helping the mother to stand on her two feet, to go over the crisis, and with dignity keep going in society, and for society to accept the mother, and for the father to take up the responsibility of fatherhood. And the responsibility, because, you know, we say it takes two to tango. It's not only the mother, but there is also the father to have a baby. So this is reality. So the more we accept each other as we are and we respect each other as being men and women, the more we have reached our fulfillment. And, you know, not men being dominant or women being dominant, but, you know, we are equal because we are equal in our nature, and we are equal because this world is ours.